We demonstrated dedication, determination, and they definitely care. And that's what I'm seeing, cares. And I think you're going to leave today maybe realizing that there's a lot, you have a lot to care about and be thankful for. So I hope they leave that message for you too. I leave you this one question. Do you believe in miracles? I think you're going to witness to today. Okay. It's my pleasure to introduce Mrs. Nicole and Brendan.
I know that life is not easy. I have not had it easy since I was
young. I made it through school with very good grades.
I made it all the way through high school graduation on June 23rd, 2007, when I graduated and walked across the stage with my high school Regents diploma. I had a full-ride scholarship to Robert Lawson in college, but I didn't make it up to Robert Lawson in college because my life kind of skidded to a halt when I was getting ready to go bowling with a bunch of friends. That the next Wednesday after I graduated, it was about 2:30, and I went to run across the road to my car to grab something. What? I don't remember, but to grab something. And I was on my cell phone, didn't look both ways before I crossed the road. The lady was speeding 137 and on her cell phone, and she hit me. Hit me on the right side, hit me and threw me diagonally across the road.
That's a close poke on my shield. That's all the blood that came out of my head. That's all the blood and my flip-flop. It's called a garage sale accident because I lost part of what I was wearing. That was me in the nursing home, my first Halloween, in a wheelchair, of course. That's me at a horse stable. That's me grooming one of the horses. I used him to ambulate. That's the first dance I went to after my accident. And that's the end.
This is my accident. Again. So you can see why I have such strong faith now. And that was it, so. Well, one point I wanted to say is that I am so thankful to finally be alive and to be as well as I am, because now, how they rate comas is on a Glasgow coma scale. It's a neurological scale, so it's how they rate how severe your coma is. And they rate it from 3 to 15. 3 is like dead. 15 is just a mild coma. You know, we always hear about people that are in a coma for like a day. That'd be a 15. Me and my wife were both 4s. So people are not supposed to come back from that. I'm so happy to be here in front of you guys. I'm so thankful to be alive. I don't know any of your personal situations, but you guys should really be thankful you're alive. I mean, I'm thankful you're alive. People don't take life seriously enough at a young age even. You're responsible for all of your actions. From even when you're a little kid, you can run out in front of a car anytime you want. And so it's important we accept the responsibility.
I just wanted to say, that you guys need to be aware of everything that's around you. Even when you see someone with a disability, we had all the disabilities. You guys probably stare at, I used to stare at them when I was younger too. Like with someone that was like kind of like mentally retarded or talked funny. I went through that. I talked funny. He talked funny. He still has a little bit of a problem with his speech. Doesn't make him any less of a person. Doesn't mean they didn't go through crazy stuff to get as good as they are. And I just want to tell you guys that if you guys have sheer determination, you can do anything. You can become whatever you want to become. Because what we're doing right now, talking to you guys, that's what I was going to, before I got hit, was going to go to college for, was motivational speaking. And I went through my accident, I got hurt, had a really long, over a year rehab, and I'm standing in front of you guys. Made it from a wheelchair, to a cane, to a walker, to a cane, and started walking.
I went to college very shortly after my accident, which was a mistake probably, because I didn't know what I wanted to do. And I used to get made fun of pretty bad. And I still, to this day, people don't treat me the same, and that's really frustrating because I'm smarter than a lot of people think. And people underestimate me all the time. And one thing that really, you know, made me mad was people would tell me my limits. No one's gonna tell me my limits but myself. I'll prove everyone wrong. I've done that my whole life. And the next thing we have,
you need to tell your parents, you need to tell your teachers, you need to tell all your friends, everything. They say you can't do it, you prove them wrong.
Right now is when you guys set up the rest of your lives. Right now is when you can either get behind in the work, and then get behind in high school, and pretty much I see a lot of kids ruin their lives right now. So you need to take it very seriously. Whatever you do now impacts the rest of your life. And it's just important to remember, because you can do anything you want. And I wish to hear that from people, and I blow them off. But honestly, with the supports they have out there now, and all the scholarships, you can really do anything you want for the rest of your life. You can set up so you have unlimited money. In the economic times, it's really hard right now. And I would love to be one of you guys right now and know what I know. So just do me a favor, take my advice, work your hardest. I know some of you aren't able to work as good as some of the other people, but if you just try your hardest all the time, you're bound to succeed.
Say knowledge is power, and you guys are like, oh, that is so corny. Oh my gosh. But guess what? You guys have the knowledge. You've heard us talk, you've heard about our experiences. Take what you've heard us tell you about and use that knowledge. And you have all the power that you need to succeed anything you want.
One more thing. No one is going to be around and say, I told you so. Whatever you do with your life is true. totally up to you. I relied on family a lot when I was your age, and I didn't take anything seriously. In high school, I was a smart aleck. Challenge authority every chance I had. I played sports and I didn't really care. But I didn't really care about anything but myself. Now I care about you guys, and I substitute for you guys, and that's so much fun. And I want to see you do your best. So just, if you're one of those people that has to prove people wrong, just do it. Yeah. I'll say congratulations at graduation, because I just got a house down the road.